Hi, I'm Judith Sullivan, and I'm a body worker here in Charlottesville, Virginia. I do cranial sacral therapy, zero balancing, lymphatic and visceral mobilization. I'm here today to talk about the Art of Touch project. This is a way to help people get back into their bodies or to feel deeper into themselves, especially if they are under any sort of stress or trauma. I did this during the August 12th demonstration here in Charlottesville, Virginia, where people were traumatized, and I was on the downtown mall and found how effective this was at helping people feel grounded again. This, though, is really for anyone to do. This is for parents, for teachers, for friends, for other body workers. Anybody that you want to work with, I would teach kids someday how to do this. I think they'd be fabulous. There are certain qualities of touch we use. These qualities of touch have been known throughout time, but I'm going to list them so that you know where to focus, because different qualities of touch can do different things to people. The qualities, first of all, we're focusing on bone, because bone carries the deepest energies of the bodies, the deepest currents, as it were. We work with high regard. No matter who comes to us, we know that each person has an essence or a higher self. We work with compassionate indifference, which doesn't mean I don't care, but it's compassion with no judgment and being able to accept whatever happens or doesn't happen. Interface is the ability to work, being aware of where you end and the other person begins. So you do not blend, and this is a way that you can do this for quite a while on many people without getting tired. We have something called donkey touch, which is how you work with the person's body as well as who they are at the same time. The blue line is where do you actually touch into that person's awareness, that consciousness. There are many different kinds of touches. You can just sort of touch someone casually on the back, or you can touch with a different awareness where they know, their body knows that you're feeling something else. And containment, which is really a pause, and that allows whatever is going to take place, energy working in the body, to actually do that. So those are the qualities that we are going to work with, or at least some of the qualities. We're going to start off working with the shoulders. Your hands are flat on their shoulders and you're compressing down as though you could feel the seat of the stool that they're going to be sitting on. This doesn't mean you're adding a lot of pressure. You're just slightly compressing down, feeling what it is that you feel. We go to the head where you place one hand sort of like a collar at the base of the skull and the other hand above the eyebrows so that you are lifting and pouring at the same time. Next, we go to the mid-back. You place one hand at the mid-back, the other hand on the shoulder, and you compress down with the hand on the shoulder, forward with the hand on the mid-back, until you feel that your hands are meeting energetically. Next, we'll work with the hips, but through the knees. Then we work with the feet. Then we work with the feet through the knees. We go back to the head, we go back to the shoulders, and we finish with a little light massage. We work on a stool because it's no problem working with the middle of the back. If they're on a stool, it would be a bit more of a problem with a chair, but you can also work with a chair. So this is Madison, and she's going to help me demonstrate the Art of Touch project. Thank you, Madison. Starting off with my hands on the shoulders, and my hands are closer to the neck than the outsides of the shoulders, and I'm just compressing down until I just feel things start to soften and relax, and as though I can feel the stool that she's sitting on. So for the head, I have one hand behind the base of her skull on the bone, and the other hand above her eyebrows, and I lift, especially with my hand at the base of the skull, and then I pour forward into my forward hand, but I'm supporting it at the same time. I bring it back. I then I'd like you to then, Madison, just turn to the side so I can show people how this is working on the back. So I place one hand on her shoulder, similar to what I did in the beginning, and the other hand right next to her spine, right around the kidneys. And I press forward with this hand and I press down with the other hand until I feel that my hands are somehow connecting energetically. I do the other one, compressing down and compressing forward with my hand on her back. Okay, thank you, Madison. You can turn forward again. Now I'm going to work with her hips from her knees. And what I'm going to be doing is I place my hands, I'm cupping my hands right at the knee joint, right above and below, and I am pulling out from her hip, that's straight out, and then I am rotating it a little bit internally, and then I come out and release. So this is a rotation like this. I pull out and then I rotate, and then come back and then let go. I'm going to do this foot on the same side. I'm compressing down using as much weight as I can because it feels so good. Coming up. You notice that once I get where my hands are in place and I compress, I then pause, which is what contains the energy and allows the energy to move in that direction. Again, on the opposite leg, my hands are in position. I connect in with Madison, and then I pull the leg forward just a little bit, and I rotate it internally just a little bit. Come back from the rotation, come back from the pull, and then I go to the foot. And my foot is, my hands are right at the ankle. They're not down here nor on the toes. They're right here. And again, I use as much of my weight as I can, compressing down.
Can you talk about what your left hand is doing on the back of the foot?
My left hand is, it's surrounding the foot bones like a collar. So I'm on the heel. I'm compressing the heel down with my hand in the back. And I'm pressing all on these bones, these tarsal bones, with my front hand. From here, so that she feels both her feet at the same time, I'm going to just compress my hands, or just here, her knees, my hands are back about an inch and a half, and I compress straight down into her feet, being aware of her feet. And coming off, you want to make sure that her feet are at about the same distance, so that one foot isn't forward and the other foot isn't back, so that you're pressing straight down. You're coming back, and you're going to repeat the head, lift, and pour it forward. Coming back, and finish with the compressing down. And finish with a little light massage of the shoulders. Just a few seconds. So, how was that?
Really great.
Is it okay?
Yeah.
Good. So, again, it's the shoulders. You can really think of it as head, shoulders, knees, and toes, but just in a slightly different order and throwing in the back. Thank you, Madison, and thank you for watching. If you want more, you can go to my website, chijude.com, that's chijude.com. I have lots more videos, and I have lots more on YouTube as well.